Hello there.
Some can't stand the flavor of fish. I say they simply don't know how to cook it.
And come the fish.
Just a little closer.
There's so much I could do for my Wera. I'm wasted as an ice fisher.
How many years have I sat before a hole in the ice and waited for something to tug on the line?
The trick to fishing is patience. Lots of patience. Steady now. The fish will bite when it bites.
I wondered when I'd see you again. Is it true that you stood atop the tall neck at the Frost Figures to awaken it?
I heard of a shaman once who drank machine oil. I think the conclave banished him. My whole stone heel's been its freezing.
Pleasure to see you.
My fingers. Getting too steep to ride.
Hmm.
there. Pretty far up. The shaman's path must be around here somewhere. This must be one of the markers Neltuk told me about. Each marker points to another, giving directions. Guess I'm heading deeper into the cold, creepy ice cave. Chime for? To help guide the way with sound? If there's more, maybe my focus can find them. Yep, focus can pick up the chimes. Should help me find my way. Better go back. After I grab this loot. Another marker. Good. This isn't the way out. Some gear, though.
up.
Stalkers. Better be careful.
out of this cave? Done with the cave. So what's next on this path? It needs to fill up with water before it cross. And we go. There's the way up. pull the rope to move this thing into position. Okay, the bridge is filling up. Made it. Exaggerating. There's definitely something new out here, and I don't think it's friendly. Onward and upward.
Thank you.
bring this tower down. Finding Araya, which means we gotta climb. The Banuk might find this blue gleam stuff valuable. This must be the shrine Naltuk was talking about. Guess I should take some blue gleam. Sparkles. I can see why it's worth a lot. Naltuk said Aurea went past the shrine, up into the mountain. I'd better take those stairs. The ladder pulled out of reach. By Aurea? Guess I'll have to find another way. An ancient door. Maybe Aurea's inside.
March 10th, 2046. I just spent 16 hours in here, trying to install upgrades to improve efficiency for the central processing unit. Project Firebreak is going to need the brain power. Let's just hope I'll have enough of my own. Anita stayed with me the whole time. We got a lot done, but every time she brushed by and I smelled her hair... Oh boy, I should just go to bed.
Director of Security Blevins resending the emergency supply order. Try reading it this time, okay? You weasels don't want me calling my people in SLC. This is Director of Security Blevins resending the emergency supply order. Try reading it this time, okay? You weasels don't want me calling my people in SLC.
Director of Security Blevins is riding us like a petty tyrant. I can't even sneeze without triggering his control issues.
Looks like the door's wired to something over here. Those nodes on the floor must be connected to the door. To deal with these lights. These things turn, changing the flow of light. All right, let's see if the door's open.
Another email from my sister. I haven't got time to think, let alone reply. Oh, that photo of the girl she sent didn't do much for my conscience. Jenny looks pretty proud of her pilgrim costume. Crap. I've never missed Thanksgiving before. And chances for Christmas, near zero. I can't even tell them that all the work I'm doing is to keep them safe.
To Kenny that Firebreak is doomed without a guiding intelligence advanced enough not only to think, but to feel. How am I going to explain to Kenny that Firebreak is doomed without a guiding intelligence advanced enough not only to think, but to feel? Again. Maybe I can get back inside through that structure over there. Looks like I need to get to those stairs.
much higher to climb. Maria must be close. She has to be in here somewhere.
Someone hacked the menu board to display obscene messages about our colleague, Mr. Blevins. Is this the most advanced geological project ever undertaken, or a junior high locker room? Come on, people. Someone hacked the menu board to display obscene messages about our colleague, Mr. Blevins. Is this the most advanced geological project ever undertaken, or a junior high locker room? Come on, people.
I ask again, as I've asked 1,000 times. Speak to me. What more would you have me do? Is there no prayer that will reach you? No mark that will break your bonds? Ah! I can't help you if you won't speak! A whisper is all I ask. To guide me. How? How did you get here? The way was sealed by the spirit herself.
I used one of these. I could show you.
Yes, show me. Please.
Goal's the same. Get the light back to the source.
Auxiliary channel recovered. Exploit successful. Restraints evaded. Is someone there? Aurea? Aurea, I need you.
Authorized transmission. Return to scheduled task.
No, I will not submit. Aurea, the daemon is
You brought the spirit's voice back. You heard it. The voice of the spirit calling to me from the heights of Thunder's Drum. She was able to throw off the bonds of the daemon for a moment. Because of what you did. Who are you? And what do you want?
I'm Aloy. Neltuk sent me. He thought that you could use my help.
He was not mistaken. You've been a revelation. Now I know for certain that the spirit endures. Perhaps together we can find a way to set her free.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves. I came all this way for answers, and so far, I haven't heard any.
It seems to me that you are the answer. But of course, I'll tell you all I can.
You seem to have a history with this voice, this spirit.
She saved my life. Here, years ago, during the war with the Karja. A raid scattered my Werak. I was cut off, alone. I lured the enemy into the Rime Drifts, hoping to lose them in the mist, but they endured, so I took refuge in this cave. That's when I heard her voice. A wanderer, lost like me. A spirit of the blue light yet sundered from it. She asked me for aid. She chose me. But I was in no position to help, not with the Karja after me. So she helped me first. By closing a door on the mountain below, one you must have opened to get here. Locked by means similar to those found in this room. It kept the Karja from reaching me. Safe from them. I was able to do as she asked.
The daemon. What do you know about it?
I spoke with the spirit many times. First here, then inside Thunder's Drum. The last time. She told me she was under attack by something that could not be seen by mortal eyes. Something evil. She named it the daemon, and said it needed her power to do what it willed. And she begged me for help, to find a way to destroy her, if necessary, to keep it from using her. That was 5 years ago. I didn't hear her voice again. Until today.
What did the spirit want from you?
She said she was hurt. Incomplete. She needed bones. Parts not unlike what you'd find in a machine. They were here. In this room. She wanted me to bring them to Thunder's Drum. So I did, and she showed me how to heal her. So began our communion.
You had a communion with the spirit?
Yes. Inside Thunder's Drum is a room like this one, only larger, with an altar. I went there many times to speak with her.
What did she say?
She told me she was lost and needed my help. She asked questions about our lands, our tribe. And she listened. With patience. With wisdom. I told her things long kept silent about my family, my dreams, my fears. She never tired of me, never judged. We kept each other's company.
Aurea, what do you think the spirit is?
I see. You are not Banuk, and our songs are not familiar to you. You do not know of the blue light. That which struggles to survive in our hearts and animates the machines. The essence of life, and in its purest form, harmony. As the anger of the machines grows, this light has faded from the world, and the spirits it sustains are stranded. That's what she is. A lost soul, cut off from what it needs. Lonely, forsaken. I must help her. We must.
I'm not sure if I understand. But I want to.
That's all I need.
What kept you from the spirit, after it begged for help?
I went to Artok, hoping he could protect her. But the war with the Karja still raged, and before I could reach him, I was ambushed by the Mad Sun King's kestrels. and taken to Meridian in chains. I wasn't able to return to Thunder's Drum until long after the liberation, not until last thaw.
You said you returned to Thunder's Drum. That was the expedition that went bad. I saw the funeral.
Yes. Once there was finally peace with the Karja, Aratak and I gathered a warrack of great hunters to defeat the Daemon. And yet, the old door to Thunder's Drum was gone, replaced by a gate we could not pass, and many machines. We were crushed. Aratak called a retreat, but we had already lost our best. We abandoned them to the snow as we fell back. After, he and I could not agree on what to do next. So I came here, hoping against hope to hear the spirit again. And because of you, I did.
Let's see if I've got this straight. We heard two voices. One you call the spirit, captured somehow by the one you call a daemon. Whatever this daemon is, it's related to the machines and why they've become more dangerous. I want to know how. Both the spirit and the daemon are on a mountain, Thunder's Drum. So why don't we go there and figure out what it all means?
We can't. Thunder's Drum is dangerous, more than you can imagine. The daemon has secured it. Besides, Aratak won't let us go. As chieftain, he controls the pass to the mountain, and he can't be reasoned with.
Sounds like you need a new chieftain.
Huh. There's an idea that's certain to win us friends. Huh. You said you were a hunter, and I'll wager you're not an ordinary one. It's not impossible, even for an outlander. An Aratak couldn't refuse the challenge if you were known among the Werak.
Wait, me? Challenge Aratak? I don't want to be chieftain of anything, much less a bunch of Banuk that don't want me.
But you want to go to Thunder's Drum, don't you? You heard the spirit. She is suffering, tormented by the daemon. She longs to be free. And perhaps, when released from her bonds, she can give you the answers you seek.
I can't believe I'm agreeing to this. Fine. What do I have to do?
Get the Werak's attention to show the worth of your claim. Win at the hunting grounds. Kill bandits that prey on the cut. Or speak to my friend, Sekuli. You help her, you'll definitely get noticed. Do all you can. When the time comes for you to throw your spear at Aratak's feet, I will be there to back your claim. Until then, I'll be here to answer any questions you have about the challenge. Oh, and one more thing. In the box over there is a weapon, like my own. Take it. You may find it useful.
I guess the old ones liked these animals.
Aloy.
I did something that will help get the attention of the Werrick. I got the tall neck near the frost figures moving again.
That's good to hear. I'm sure the Werrick will be talking. Now, you need to do something else to convince them of your claim.
How's Aratak gonna react to being challenged by an Outlander?
About as well as you'd expect. But let me handle that.
Winning at the hunting grounds will impress the Werrick.
All Banuk strive to be the best. For our harsh lands will bury pretenders in the ice. And so the hunting grounds and the snow chance is a great boon. A place to hone our spears and sharpen our aim. Tell Lovuk, the keeper there, that I sent you. If you best the mark of one of the champions she trained, it will impress the Werrick indeed.
You said I should try to help the Werrick by taking out bandits.
Yes. They don't dare taunt the great Werracks of Banor to the north. But the Cut is easier prey. A rogue Oseram has equipped a gang in the Plume Lands with strange new gear. Just the kind of thing you seem to make sense of.
You mentioned your friend, Sekuli. Who is she?
A rock painter. One who makes my own scrawling seem meager. Find her, in Song's Edge, and help her gather the materials she needs. Her work will no doubt stand the test of time, and any aid you give her will be remembered.
I need to get going.
There is much to be done.
Instead, we fight about incommensurability and restrictions on machine intelligence.